you don't know Donna like I do. I mean, missing Versailles was one thing, but a day of shopping? Now, that's serious. I mean, I can't believe she missed it. She had to run off to La Chute.
What do you expect? She's the center of attention. She's being fawned over and admired. And I hear Pierre's no slouch himself.
Come on, she is crazy about her boyfriend.
Uh-huh.
No, you just don't know Donna.
But I do know Paris. And I do know older men. And I do know the modeling scene. I did a few jobs myself in New York.
So what does that mean?
It means that if Donna is as naive as you say she is, she's got a rude awakening coming.
You know what, Maggie? Maybe you're right.
I know I'm right.
So do you have another one of those? Merci.
Let's face it, Brenda. Sooner or later, with the camera or without it, Monsieur Pierre is going to want Mademoiselle Donna to take her clothes off.
These are really good.
Why don't you just tell him the truth? Because it's fun. And I've gone too far to go back now. Besides, he might get pretty mad at me.
So, what if he does?
Donna, he's a really nice guy. I mean, he's easygoing, he's fun, he's gonna be a writer.
And you're just helping him gather material, right?
Must you do that in here, Maggie? Brenda!
Donna, when in Rome.
Can we please go get something to eat before I completely lose my appetite?
Appelez-vous, mademoiselles.
What name did you use?
Brenda, of course. He bought it.
Unbelievable.
Do you have any matches?
I cannot believe you are smoking.
Don't worry, it's my last one. Everybody smokes in Paris. Do you want a drag?
Oh, get away from me with that.
I just had this dress dry cleaned. You know, if your parents catch you, you're dead.
Yeah, well, what are they gonna do, not invite Dylan to my party?
Have you talked to him yet?
No, I'm waiting till everybody leaves. I cannot wait to hear his voice in the same time zone.
It's weird, but in the back of my mind, I sort of thought that you being in Paris might change things with you guys.
Can you keep a secret?
I think so.
Well, right before we were leaving, I met this really cute guy from the University of Wisconsin, and he actually believed that I was French.
You're kidding me.
He was completely fooled, mon chéri.
Oh, what happened?
Well, he wanted me to go backpacking with him, and I came really close to doing it. But instead, I turned around and went to the airport and never even said goodbye.
Wow.
You know, part of me just wanted to take off with him. But I kept thinking about how much I loved Dylan. And I just couldn't. Boy, was I tempted.
Temptation can be a killer.
So, what did you do all summer?
Spent a lot of time with the baby.
Brenda, I was hoping I'd find you.
You got a minute?
Sure. I want you to know I had nothing to do with that smear on your friend's mom.
You came all the way here just to tell me that?
Can we go somewhere and talk?
Believe me, working for Backstory was not where I thought I'd end up after journalism school. But jobs are hard to come by.
Well, I guess you gotta do what you gotta do.
Well, I still think I can do the kind of quality work that bucks convention and breaks down the stereotypes. But I need your help.
Beth, I don't know.
It's a natural. Come on. Stay tuned for the backstory on the kids that go to high school in the most glamorous city in America.
How is that going to break down any stereotypes?
Because I'm not going to do a generic profile of the blonde bimbette on Rodeo Drive with her daddy's gold card. What interests me is that you and your friends are just a bunch of ordinary kids living in an extraordinary community.
Yeah, I guess Beverly Hills can take some getting used to.
Which is a lot easier if you get past the surface glitz and look at the difference between what's real and what's hype, right?
Do you have another cigarette?
So when did you start smoking?
I was in Paris for the summer. Everybody was doing it.
I started my senior year, too. Actually, your friends remind me of the crowd I used to hang out with in high school. We're still really close. So, what do you say?
Well, do I get to be on camera?
Hey, Dad, what's up? Going out someplace, big guy?
Yes, if your mother ever finds the address. How are you guys?
Great.
Pete.
All set.
Finally, I'm starved.
Well, don't study too hard.
She will.
Well, don't party too hard. See you later. Night.
This is the thanks we get for sending you to Paris.
Everybody smokes in Paris.
Well, no one smokes in this house. It's that simple.
I don't know anyone who smokes anymore.
It really is a disgusting habit, Brent.
Look, I've only smoked a couple of times. I don't even inhale hardly, so you can all stop worrying.
Aren't there enough health hazards we can't control without you voluntarily adding another?
Dad, if I can survive the smog in the air, the pesticides in my food, and the crime in the streets, then I am bound to beat the odds on a couple of lousy cigarettes.
Don't you dare make light of this.
Mom, I'm sorry. I just think you're all overreacting.
Well, then you have a short memory. Think back to when you had to see Dr. Donner about that lump in your breast. Or do we have to refresh your memory about this family's medical history when it comes to cancer?
No.
Okay. Listen. So she lost her perspective over there with the Frenchies this summer. That's fine. But now that she's back...
Brandon, please shut up.
Do any of your friends smoke?
No, Dad. And I don't either. I mean, somebody gave me that pack. In fact, I can quit any time.
Well, in that case, now is just as good a time as any, right?
No problem. No thanks.
Dad will be off in a minute.
Wow, you have like a whole command post set up here, don't you?
Yeah, Backstory has 15 mobile units around the country. We can edit right in here. It gives us a lot of options. You sure you can't stay and help me?
A lot of people can't get past her looks and see what a smart and loving and caring person she really is.
You know, you're really good at this.
Thanks. Can I have one of those?
Sure. Help yourself. I'm sorry, Brenda.
It's okay. It was for a good cause. You don't have a spare toothbrush by any chance, do you?
No.